Hello everyone. In this video, I will explain about equivalent weight. What is the equivalent weight? Equivalent weight is the amount of substance which can completely react or which can replace 1 gram of hydrogen or 8 grams of oxygen or 35.5 grams of chlorine. That is its equivalent weight. So here, equivalent weight of any substance which displaces 1 gram of hydrogen or 8 grams of oxygen or 35.5 grams of chlorine. So that amount we can call its equivalent weight. Then how to calculate this equivalent weight for a substance? So here equivalent weight is different for the same substance, that depends its the chemical reaction. So sometimes the substance may have one kind of equivalent weight, will it undergoes either oxidation reaction or reduction reaction, or sometimes it may act as a salt, or sometimes it may act as a acid. It depends on the condition. Then how to calculate that equivalent weight? So here equivalent weight of any substance is equals to molecular weight of that substance by its N factor. N factor, or we can call valency factor. So what is the N factor or valency factor? This already I explained in my previous video. So for that, you can see in the description, you can find the link for N factor and you can check what is the N factor there. Now here, equivalent weight for different substances in different cases. First, let us take atoms case. So how to calculate equivalent of the weight of the atoms? So for atoms, as already I told, that N factor is its valency. So equivalent weight for atoms is equals to atomic weight of that element by its valency is the equivalent weight of that atom. Let's take some examples here. For example, if you take hydrogen atom, its atomic weight is 1 and valency is 1. So equivalent weight of hydrogen is equals to 1. If you take oxygen, its atomic weight is 16 and the valency of oxygen is 2. So that is 8 grams is its equivalent weight. So now if you take nitrogen, atomic mass 14. The valency for nitrogen is 3, that will give 4.6 grams. Similarly, you take magnesium, here 24, the atomic weight, the magnesium valency is 2, that will give the equivalent weight is 12. Similarly, if you take aluminium, aluminium atomic weight 27 and its valency is 3. So that is 9 is the equivalent weight of aluminium. So just we have to take atomic weight by its valency to calculate atom's equivalent weight. Next, equivalent weight of ions. And second here, ions. So for ions, N factor is equals to the charge present on the ion. So equivalent weight of ions is equals to, if it is ion is from single atom, so atomic weight of that ion. If it is a polyatomic ion, the molecular weight of that ion. So here atomic weight or molecular weight of that ion by again its N factor. एन फैक्टर हियर इज चार्ज. सो नाउ लेट अस टेक एग्जांपल्स. लेट अस टेक एनी ए प्लेस. सोडियम आयन, द एन फैक्टर फॉर सोडियम आयन, एटॉमिक वेट ऑफ सोडियम इज 23. The charge of sodium ion is 1. So, its atomic weight 23. If I take carbonate 2-, here it is a polyatomic ion. The molecular weight of carbonate, this is 60 and its charge is 2. So, it is 30. Similarly, SO4 2-, here ions, the molecular weight is sulfate 96 by 2, that will give 48. Similarly, HSO4-, here charge is 1, so this is 97 by 1, it is equals to 97. So like this we can calculate the ion's equivalent weight. Just if it is an atom, atomic weight is the molecule, molecular weight by its charge present on overall atom or ion. And next, the third case, n factor for acids and bases. So, in case of acids, N factor is its basicity. So, equivalent weight of the acid is equals to, its a molecular weight of acid by its basicity. Again, let us take some examples here. HCl, a basic example. Here, the molecular mass is 36.5. Here, N factor or basicity for HCl is 1. So, equivalent weight is 36.5. And take HNO3, this is a 63 molecular weight. Again, N factor is 1. So, equivalent weight of HNO3 is 63. Next, H2SO4, this is 98 molecular weight, here N factor is 2, so 49 is the equivalent weight. Next, oxalic acid, this is 90 and the N factor again 2, that is 45. Some special cases for H3PO2, and here H3PO2 molar mass is 66, but N factor for H3PO2 is 1 only here, it is not 3. Already I explained in the N factor video. Again, if you can check the link in the description, you can find out the N factor for H3PO2. Next, H3PO3. Here the molar mass of H3PO3 is 82, and again the N factor for H3PO3 here is 2, and that will give 41 is the equivalent weight. Next, H3PO4, here 98 is the molar mass, N factor for H3PO4 is 3, so that will give 32.6 is the equivalent weight. In case of H3PO2, H3PO3 and H3PO4, the N factors are 1, 2, 3 respectively. So, these are the N factor, equivalent weights for acids. And next, equivalent weight for bases. So here n factor for base is its acidity. Again, the equivalent weight of base is molecular weight of base Y. Its acidity or n factor. Now, some examples. Sodium hydroxide. The molecular weight of sodium hydroxide is 40. Here, acidity for sodium hydroxide is 1. So, equivalent weight 40. Next student, calcium hydroxide. Where the molecular mass of calcium hydroxide is 74 and here acidity is 2. Then the equivalent weight of calcium hydroxide is 37. And now aluminium hydroxide. The molecular mass of aluminium hydroxide is 78. The n factor or acidity for aluminium hydroxide is 3. So overall the equivalent weight is 26. So this is an equivalent weight per basis. Next, salts. So in case of salts, the equivalent weight is again the molecular weight by n factor. Now the n factor for salts is here the total positive or total negative charge. Total positive or total negative charge. Again, the formula for equivalent weight of salts is equals to molecular weight of salt by the total positive or total negative charge. Now, examples. Let us take sodium chloride. Sodium chloride, the total positive or negative is 1. The molecular mass of sodium chloride is 58.5 by 1. This is 58.5. And sodium carbonate. Here the molecular mass is 106. The n factor for this is 2. Hence it is 53 is the n factor for sodium carbonate. Next, calcium carbonate. The molar mass is 100 and by 2. Then you will get 50 is the equivalent weight of calcium carbonate. Sodium bicarbonate. 84 is the molar mass and here n factor is 1. So that is 84. Similarly, some other salts. Aluminium sulfate. So here the total positive or negative, that is n factor for aluminium sulfate is 6 and the molar mass is 342. So 342 by 6. And the n factor is 57. And next we have Morse salt. The formula is ferrous sulfate, ammonium sulfate, six H2O. This is the Morse salt. Again here, The equivalent weight of this Mohr's salt is, the molecular weight of Mohr's salt is 392 by the n factor for Mohr's salt is 4. So the equivalent weight is 98 here. And these are the some equivalents of salts. And next we have some substance which undergoes redox reaction. That is the equivalent weight of oxidizing agents and reducing agents. Here, oxidizing agent and reducing agent. So for oxidizing or reducing agent, n factor is equals to the total number of electron transfer. Per molecule. So equivalent weight of the reducing or oxidizing agent is equals to the molecular weight of oxidizing agent or reducing agent by its n factor. Let's take some examples here. KMnO4. Generally, KMnO4 is a strong oxidizing agent. So, it undergoes reduction in various ways like this. In acidic medium, it will convert it into the Mn2+. In neutral medium, it will convert it to Mn4+. And in basic medium, it will be converted to Mn6+. The equivalent weight of KMnO4 is now different in different cases. Why? Because the n factor is different in different mediums. So first, in acidic medium, the equivalent weight of KMnO4 is equals to, the total molecular weight is 158, and here n factor is 5 in acidic medium. So that will give overall 31.6 is the equivalent weight. Similarly, in neutral medium, the equivalent weight of KMnO4 158 by 3, and that is 52.6 is its equivalent weight. Similarly, in alkali medium, the equivalent weight is 158 by 1, and that is 158. Next, we have potassium dichromate. That is also one of the important oxidizing agent. Potassium dichromate. Potassium dichromate in acidic medium is converted as chromium 3+. Now here, n factor for potassium dichromate is 6. So equivalent weight is equals to, again, molecular weight by 6. And molecular weight of potassium dichromate is 294. And by 6, that will give 49 is the equivalent weight of potassium dichromate. Now see some other examples of redox reactions and their equivalent weights. Here, ferrous oxalate, it undergoing oxidation as iron 3+ and carbon dioxide. Now the equivalent weight of ferrous oxalate here. So equivalent weight is equals to molecular weight of ferrous oxalate is 144. Now, the overall n factor for ferrous oxalate is 3. Then that will give 48. Similarly, in this case, bromine, it undergoing both oxidation and reduction simultaneously. This is the example for redox disproportionation reaction. One of the redox reaction under disproportionation reactions. Here, the equivalent weight of bromine is, the molecular weight is 160 by n factor for bromine here is 5/3. So that we can write by 5/3. the overall it will give 96 is the equivalent weight of bromine. So these are the some calculations of equivalent weights of various atoms, ions and molecules, oxidizing and reducing agents. And overall here we can observe out of all these points, this is very very important note, that is molecular weight of a substance is constant, is always constant, but equivalent weight of substance is not constant. So here equivalent weight of substance, it may be equal to molecular weight sometime, it may be less than to molecular, or it may be more than the molecular weight also. So it is variable that depends on the reaction conditions.
If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel.